Thanks for joining us on the CBN News Channel. I'm Heather Sells. There is a major break in the case against the American missionaries accused of trying to smuggle children out of Haiti. Most of them are free and back on U.S. soil this morning. Now, from Graham has more.
This is a long-awaited answer to prayer for families of the missionaries back here in the U.S., but two of the 10 will remain behind bars in Haiti for further questioning. Eight of the U.S. missionaries landed in Miami this morning aboard a military cargo plane after spending nearly a month in a Haitian jail.
We have been praying so hard for them, so we're just glad that God has answered our prayers favorably and can't wait to see them.
One of the missionaries accused of trying to illegally take 33 children out of the earthquake-stricken country is a Topeka, Kansas firefighter and a youth pastor.
We knew his character. We knew the reason why he went. We knew the accusations that were made against him were not accurate.
Other missionaries in the group are members of Central Valley Baptist Church in Idaho.
Obviously, I'm very happy about my wife coming home and excited that they all, most of them are coming home. But again, there are two that are still there that we are still praying for to come home.
One of the two missionaries still being held in Haiti for more questioning is the group's leader, Laura Silsby.
I am trusting God to reveal all truth and that we will be released and exonerated of charges. And we are just waiting for the Haitian process, legal process to complete.
The eight missionaries who are now back on U.S. soil returned without their passports and personal gear. They could be called back to Haiti for further questioning in the case. Reporting in the newsroom, Ephraim Graham, CBN News.
Thanks, Ephraim. Damage from last month's earthquake in Haiti may be twice the value of Haiti's economy. That is according to a new report by economists with Inter-American Development Bank. It's estimated the quake caused between $8 and $14 billion in damage. But Haiti only produces about $7 billion worth of goods and services each year. Joining us today to talk more about ongoing needs in Haiti is Christina Christensen, a nurse from Virginia Beach. And Christina, your short-term missions team from Gateway Free Will Baptist landed in Haiti on the day of the earthquake, and you were immediately put to work. How did you see Haitians responding in the midst of that amazing tragedy?
Mm-hmm. Many of them were in a state of chaos, didn't really understand what had just happened. But as we drove more through the city, we saw Haitians praising the Lord and preaching. And I had a Haitian in the back seat with me, so he was interpreting for me. And then others were wailing and bringing people into medical facilities. Mm-hmm. So you saw a spectrum of both people weeping and not understanding what's happening and others saying, you know, Jesus is returning, we need to repent. And so you saw a spectrum.
All kinds of emotions. And as the weeks were going on, how were you seeing the Haitians cope with just their lives crumbling?
Mm-hmm. We had a lot of patients come into the clinic that were emotionless as they said that both of my parents died in the earthquake. I'm the only one that survived from my house. Others were accepting of it and were thankful for the Lord sparing their life and saw God as their protector. And so many of them cope very differently than Americans, where we would be grieving, and I know I would be, and many of them, they don't have any other choice than to get back on their feet and continue living.
To survive.
Mm-hmm.
There was one three-month-old baby that made an impression on you. You really saw God working in his little life. Mm-hmm. Tell us about that.
They found him with an injury to his thigh and burns on both of his legs because he was exposed to the sun for 2 days. And this baby, over the next 3 weeks, I would do daily dressing changes and burn care. And God's hand was on this baby. He would sleep through most of his dressing changes, whereas in the States, we often give sedation and pain medication. And the last day I was there, we had to take him to a facility because his legs started to worsen.
And God was really watching over him, it sounds like.
He was. And now he's actually at CHOP, Children's Hospital of Philadelphia, getting American care for free. And so it's really neat to see God protect his life. And I know he has a plan for him.
Just in the short time we have left, tell us about you're going back to Haiti, and there's a lot of ongoing medical needs that I think we wouldn't think of. Tell us what kind of medical needs still exist in Haiti because of the earthquake.
Mm-hmm. So in Haiti, many of these patients and Haitians have big wounds that they're going to need multiple months to heal. And so they're healing from the inside out. So standard wound care for months, as well as many amputees that need daily care and cleaning and watching the wounds.
Absolutely. Christina Christensen, thanks for joining us.
You're welcome.
The Catholic Archdiocese of Washington, D.C. will no longer provide foster care services because of the city's gay marriage law. Catholic Charities transferred its entire program to the nonprofit National Center for Children and Families. A same-sex marriage law soon to take effect in D.C. could require the charity to let gay couples serve as foster parents. Officials say that would violate church teaching on homosexuality. A new political statement seeks to unify conservatives around the country by recommitting to constitutional conservatism. More than 80 conservative leaders representing groups like the Family Research Council and Concerned Women for America signed the Mount Vernon statement near Washington, D.C. Wednesday. They believe positive change means embracing the country's founding principles rather than seeking new approaches.
Our simple message here today is to go forward. We must look back. We needn't, and nothing in this statement does, reinvent the wheel. To go forward, we must preserve those constitutional principles that are being highlighted today in the Mount Vernon statement.
The Mount Vernon statement recalls the signing of a similar document, the Sharon Statement, in 1960 at the home of National Review editor William F. Buckley. U.S.-led troops are gaining ground in Afghanistan in the biggest offensive there since 2001. Military commanders have raised the Afghan flag in the bullet-ridden main market in Marja. But fighting remains intense in other parts of this Taliban stronghold. Marja is the hub of the Taliban's southern logistics and drug smuggling network. NATO hopes to rush in aid and public services as soon as the town is secured to try and win the loyalty of the population. Israel is set to become the first country with a nationwide power grid to recharge electric cars. Chris Mitchell shows us how one company is helping Israel take this giant green step.
It started as a question to young global leaders. What could they do to make the world a better place? Israeli businessman Shai Agassi took the challenge. His approach? Freeing the world from its oil addiction through electric cars.
To do that, you need a new system that takes care of transportation as a holistic approach, not just a car, because much like gasoline cars wouldn't work without gas stations, electric cars wouldn't work without the right infrastructure to make them convenient and affordable for consumers.
Agassi hopes to set up that infrastructure in Israel by 2011. Electricity for the grid would be generated, when possible, by renewable sources. The plan would use computer software to manage Israel's flow of electricity so the power grid doesn't get overloaded during peak hours. The cars would recharge at spots installed in public parking lots, at work, and at home. So every time the car is parked, it would be plugged in and recharging. For long trips, switch stations would allow you to swap your battery robotically for a fresh one in less than 2 minutes.
Whenever batteries come into the switch station, we perform health checks on them.
Quinn Garcia says routine maintenance should be cheaper.
You don't have things like oil filters and oil to change and even the brakes. Because you have the regenerative braking feature, the brakes actually last much longer than they would on a typical vehicle.
Agassi's company, Better Place, will initially partner with car manufacturer Renault. But executives say they're in talks with all car makers. Agassi is pledging to make the cars more convenient and affordable than gasoline cars. He says the cost of setting up the privately funded grid would amount to the cost of one tank of gas per car in Israel.
Imagine we can get the entire United States off oil at the cost of one gas tank per car in the country.
Denmark and Australia are already moving toward using the system, and the U.S., Canada, and Japan are also interested. Better Place recently opened a visitor center in Israel, but many Israelis are skeptical. Some say the company is creating a monopoly, whereby car owners will be trapped into costly service and supply contracts. Agassi sees Better Place as part of Israel's calling.
In the Bible, it says that Israel is Or LaGoyim, it's the light for nations. And to a certain degree, Israel's recently been branded, if you want, as a center for global problems. It's the first time Israel picks up a global problem that was not started in Israel. but solves the problem and takes that solution and exports it out to the rest of the world.
Chris Mitchell, CBN News, Central Israel.
President Obama is hoping to create a new agency that studies and reports on global warming. The new climate service would operate hand in hand with the National Weather Service. The new agency will be in Washington, D.C., and led by six regional directors around the country. The president's proposal will need congressional approval. The administration expects the agency to be in place by the end of the year. The rapidly increasing U.S. government debt is a concern for foreign investors. China has reduced its stake in U.S. Treasury securities, and it is no longer the biggest holder of those investments. Japan has moved back to number one. Some analysts say China's move doesn't amount to much, but others warn it's a warning signal that foreign countries are worried that the U.S. government spending is out of control. That could mean that interest rates on U.S. treasuries could have to start going up to attract foreign investors. Coming up, a look at the role of faith in African American history and why this historic church is so important.
Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart.
These are the most powerful songs of our time.
Come, now is the time to worship.
And now, for the first time, the biggest praise and worship songs are together.
How great is our God.
Presenting Songs for Worship 50. 50 songs in one specially priced collection.
Oh, he is the Lord God Almighty. The earth is filled.
You'll hear 50 beautiful songs of hope.
I'm coming back to the heart of worship. And it's
50 powerful songs of faith. Get Songs for Worship 50 on three CDs for only
$24.99.
But wait, order in the next 10 minutes with your credit card and we'll take $15 off. That's right. You get 50 praise and worship songs for just
$9.99.
Then preview other great praise and worship collections. Satisfaction guaranteed. So call now and get Songs for Worship 50. 50 beautiful songs on three CDs for just
$9.99.
Call 1-800-435-3414 to order Songs for Worship 50 on three CDs for $9.99 plus shipping and handling when you use your credit card. Call now or order online at timelife.com/songsforworship50.
Welcome back to the CBN News Channel. As we celebrate Black History Month, we consistently discover how important faith and the church have been to African Americans. One of those examples is Bethel United Methodist Church in Charleston, South Carolina. Charlene Israel shows us why this historic church is what's known as the Low Country is so special.
On any given day, a trip to Charleston, South Carolina will tempt your senses. You're bound to hear music on the street corners and neat treats on every corner. But about a mile away from the old slave market on Calhoun Street, you'll find a little known black history fact. Old Bethel United Methodist Church sits on a lot virtually untouched by time.
We are the mother church.
Old Bethel, as it's lovingly called, was built in 1797. And unlike many churches of the time, its doors were open to everyone. According to Ann Taylor Andrus, historian at Bethel United Methodist Church, Methodists took up the cause to fight slavery.
When John Wesley came here in 1736 and 1737, he saw black people being held as slaves, and he was horrified.
Despite their welcome, the races were separated.
The white used to be downstairs and the black used to be upstairs.
The church was originally called Bethel Methodist Episcopal Church, and it sat on the corner of Pitt and Calhoun Streets, where the current Bethel United Methodist Church sits. The black members sat in the gallery until 1851.
In most of the early Methodist history here, the black members far outnumbered the white members.
Old Bethel's pastor, Timothy Bowman, explains the reason for this.
The day of worship was the most meaningful day of their lives and their experience because they know that they were somebody.
And it was during this time that the church split. According to church records, the blacks were using their tithes and offerings to purchase the freedom of the slaves in the congregation, and that unsettled some.
By 1830s, 1840 period, the Methodists did not speak out publicly against slavery as much as they had in the past.
And so, in 1876, the white members gave the church to the black members.
This church was rolled across the street when the members over there built their church.
The fact that the black members moved the church makes many very proud.
You feel somewhat in awe.
And the fact that the church still contains many of its original features amazes many.
The pulpit and the chairs are the original with this church, and that John Wesley preached from that pulpit.
And those aren't the only original features in the church. Pews that the slaves sat in are still intact. Some of the glass panes in the windows are the originals. The ceiling is made of cast iron. The building is on the National Register of Historic Places.
We can't do anything in the sanctuary but maintain it.
And despite the great earthquake of 1886 and Hurricane Hugo, which took direct aim at the Charleston area in 1989, Old Bethel stands strong.
It has its own history. It's making history. Every worship experience is making history.
Charlene Israel, CBN News.
Up next, the nation's divorce rate keeps going up, but in this town, it's dropped by 70%. So what's their secret?
Israel, the land where God came to mankind. Imagine to be in the place where our Lord lived, the stand where he performed his miracles, the sea where he taught the multitudes. The pages of the Bible come alive in the land filled with God's promises. Don't miss this experience of a lifetime. Visit Israel. You'll never be the same.
Call today.
Each week, thousands of concerned parents and grandparents start Globe Young American plans for their children and grandchildren. The Young American plan is a simple, affordable way to secure valuable life insurance protection. Starting a Young American plan today guarantees the future insurability of your loved ones. Once issued, the Young American plan can never be canceled. For just $1, you can start a Young American plan and feel safe knowing you've provided your child or grandchild with a lifetime of protection. The regular premium you establish now is guaranteed to never increase. And the Young American plan builds cash value that can be used in the future. Since 1964, millions of concerned parents and grandparents have started Globe Young American plans for their children and grandchildren. Call Globe today.
Call right now for complete information about the Globe Young American Plan. Call Globe today at 1-800-457-4154.
Israel, the land where God came to mankind. Imagine to be in the place where our Lord lived, the stand where he performed his miracles, the sea where he taught the multitudes. The pages of the Bible come alive in the land filled with God's promises. Don't miss this experience of a lifetime. Visit Israel. You'll never be the same.
Call today.
It's no secret that many marriages in the U.S. are in trouble. So two Christian leaders in Kansas decided to find ways to help couples stay together and build stronger families. As Paul Strand reports, they succeeded.
Many Americans seem to just accept the nation's 50% divorce rate. However, there are proven methods to make marriages last, and whole communities can take advantage.
Like most places, the divorce rate in Kansas City, Missouri has been going up. But right across the state line here in Kansas City, Kansas, It's been going down. What's made the difference?
In 1996, suburban pastor Jeff Myers teamed up with urban pastor Leroy Sullivan to fight for marriage.
If it fails, it's the pebble in the pond, the waves that reverberate out go on for generations. Then I thought, where's the church? This is our issue. This is the thing we should be dealing with.
And we're so busy talking about let's go to heaven, we never teach people how to live on earth.
Myers and Sullivan spent months recruiting dozens of other pastors in the Kansas City, Kansas area to sign a community marriage policy, a pledge to fight hard to make marriages last. And over the next 10 years, the town saw an amazing 70% plunge in the divorce rate, from 650 in 1995 to just 196 in 2005. One method focused on recruiting and training couples with long-lasting marriages to become mentors, working especially with those about to marry. The DeFreeses have mentored for 14 years.
You're using your years of experience, coupled with some training and listening skills and communication skills.
The Llewellyns have mentored a dozen young couples.
How well do you know each other, and are you really meant to be together? Just because you love each other, it doesn't mean you're called to be life-term partners.
These marriage coaches help couples who want to wed take a premarital inventory, which can predict with 80% accuracy which couples will likely divorce.
We've had, I know, two decide not to marry.
And mentors help young couples seriously consider areas of potential trouble.
The preparation process lots of times brings out areas that maybe they've never discussed before or thought about.
We have the communication tools to give and take and find, you know, how you're going to work together.
Pastors in more than 220 communities have now signed community marriage policies, offering pre-marriage exams and mentoring couples. Mike McManus of Marriage Savers has championed these concepts for decades. Now he's pushing more ideas in how to cut America's divorce rate in half. The U.S. rate is triple that of France and Britain, and McManus thinks one big reason is because of the waiting periods for a divorce in those nations.
You have to wait 5 years in one country and 6 years in the other to get the divorce. You know what happens in 5 years? A lot of reconciliation.
Myers says research shows if those in a failing marriage would simply wait it out for 5 years, they'd likely see a big turnaround.
66% of those couples will report a stronger, happier, wholesome marriage if they will just do that much.
McManus would like states to legislate a 2-year waiting period and get rid of no-fault divorce for couples with minor children, unless there's abuse or adultery.
What is called no-fault divorce means unilateral divorce.
He wants states to replace it with mutual consent divorce so both spouses have a say.
Here are two reforms, either one of which, in many states, could cut the divorce rate in half.
It'd also save a huge amount of taxpayer dollars. Taxpayers cough up $112 billion a year to pay the huge costs of families fragmenting.
They're eligible for Medicaid and food stamps and earned income tax credit and subsidies for housing and daycare and all that. That's what costs so much.
Only 1% of married women are poor, but 24% of divorced women are.
It's a devastating thing. Divorces within our communities, families, and the lives of our children personally to societally.
Which is why saving marriages could do so much for a society.
I really believe in what we're doing is making eternal benefits to couples down the road.
Marriage is really the best solution for all the problems we have in our society today.
Sullivan's only had a couple of divorces in his church since his fellow pastors banded together in 1996. And as for Myers' church,
I have roughly 100 weddings that I've performed since then. I've had no divorces.
If we have a culture promoting marriage and our churches begin to capture the vision that they can be marriage savers, I think we could drive down this divorce rate nationally in half.
So as folks are showing here in Kansas City, Kansas, we don't have to accept a 50% divorce rate. And marriage, for almost everyone, can truly be the lifelong institution it was always meant to be. Paul Strand, CBN News, reporting from Kansas City, Kansas.
Thanks, Paul. Tiger Woods' agent says he will make a public appearance Friday to make amends for the scandal that cost him his reputation. Woods will speak to a select group of reporters at the PGA headquarters near Jacksonville, Florida. Many are wondering not just about his personal problems, but whether he'll return to professional golf. The Masters tournament begins in 7 weeks. Well, the U.S. won 3 gold medals at the Vancouver Olympics on Thursday and now leads the medal count with 14 overall. Lindsey Vonn took the gold at the women's downhill despite an injured shin. On the ice track, speed skater Shawnee Davis broke his own record to win the 1,000 meters. And snowboarder Sean White showed off a bold new move to claim the top prize in the half pipe. We'll be right back.
Introducing Easy Combs, the easy new way to create dazzling new dos. Simply slide in one end, stretch it around your hair, and slide in on the other side for an updo that's brand new, or fluff it out for a fountain effect. Look again. The bungee band stretch and release for a relaxed custom fit every time. Liven up a ponytail or create this amazing butterfly twist. It's great for short hair and ideal for the office. It's perfect for any formal occasion. Ouch, claw clips hurt, but Easy Combs are soft and comfortable, so easy to use, kids love them too. Now get Easy Combs in caramel bronze for only $10. Call now and get one in dazzling silver. As a special bonus, get our Bermuda Black plus a styling DVD. Just pay separate shipping and handling. With the step-by-step DVD, Easy Combs are a cinch. You get caramel, silver, and black, plus the style guide and DVD, a $60 value, all for only $10.
Call 1-800-520-1486. You'll get the bonus Easy Combs as advertised when you call 1-800-520-1486.
Love to shop for shoes, but there's no place to store them? You're always running out of room to store more. Introducing Shoes Under, the easy solution to organize and protect your shoes. The clear zipper cover locks out dust and moisture. Now you just slide and store. It's that easy. With two handles, you can easily store your shoes here, under there, almost everywhere, and turn an empty space into a super storage place. Other shoe organizers can cost a fortune, but through this exclusive television offer, you can get the 12-compartment Shoes Under for only $19.99. Call now and we'll cut that price in half. That's right, for only $10. And as a bonus, we'll double the offer and give you a second Shoes Under that's enough space for 48 shoes. Just pay separate shipping and handling. Call now and get two Shoes Under for only $10.
Call 1-800-943-1652. You'll get a second one free, so call 1-800-943-1652. That's 1-800-943-1652. Call now.
Finally, today, in the aftermath of the Haiti earthquake, we've heard a lot of stories of fundraising events to help the Haitians recover. And here's another great one to report out of Houston, Texas. She is being called the Flying Nun. Sister Jane Meyer is head of St. Agnes Academy. She agreed to take her first skydive if the school could raise $25,000 to fund Haiti relief efforts.
It's the most exhilarating thing ever. You feel like you're flying. But, you know, it's the wind is so strong up there. You know, I wanted to try and wave and everything, and the wind is so strong. But it's beautiful. Once you start coming down, it's the most beautiful sight ever. Just to see you just feel so glad. I feel so close to God, I'll tell you for sure. And of course, I kept thinking about the people in Haiti and all that they're going through.
Well, the teacher's motivation worked. They have already raised more than $40,000. And that's all for this hour of the CBN News Channel. You can find information on all the stories that you've seen here at CBNNews.com. And you can also stay up to date with CBN News through Facebook and Twitter. We hope you'll join us next time. Have a great day.
Daddy?
Yeah, buddy?
How many nickels are in a dollar?
There are 20 nickels in a dollar.
How do birds fly? Does milk really make my bones stronger?
Yeah.
Daddy, when we die, will we go to heaven?
Do you have the answer to life's biggest question? Call the 700 Club. We'll help you find answers to the important questions life brings your way.
Fresh, wholesome juice. There's nothing like it. But until now, you had to stress and strain and make a huge mess to get just a little bit of juice. But not anymore, thanks to the Jack LaLanne Power Juicer. You can drop in whole vegetables, whole fruits, apples, oranges, celery, cucumbers with no chopping, no slicing, no struggling. And thanks to the Power Juicer's revolutionary patented extraction technology, you can get up to 30% more juice than those other juicers. Doctors recommend we get 5 to 9 servings of fruits and vegetables every day. With the Power Juicer, you'll be drinking your recommended daily allowance in just seconds. And the pulp from the extra large pulp catcher can be used to make pasta sauces, healthy desserts, and much more. The Power Juicer is dishwasher safe, so cleanup's a breeze, and the powerful motor is guaranteed for life. Order the Jack LaLanne Power Juicer now for just 2 easy payments of $49.90. And as part of this special TV offer, we'll also send you this amazing recipe guide filled with over 60 of Jack's favorite recipes. Try the Jack LaLanne Power Juicer in your home risk-free for 30 days. If you're not completely satisfied, send it back for a full refund of the purchase price, no questions asked. Call now.